Where are we? There we are. I scare myself. Surrounded by two of dead or alive. Pete Burns and Steve. I think you can give them a round of applause and welcome them, can't you? Embarrassment. Congratulations on your first hit, number 40.
Yeah. Congratulations on my first hit, number 40. What more can you say? At last.
It's taken a long time, though. I'm the first of the sort of new breed of glam rock stars as such, and the last to actually ever hear. Frustrating, I imagine.
No, not really. It wasn't that frustrating at all. It was bound to happen eventually anyway, but at least we built quite a good foundation to carry on from, because there's quite a lot of die-hard fans and everything. It wasn't just a quick hit and then a flop, you know. I think we'll keep going for a while now.
The tour which you're underway at the moment has been going well. Sell out, yeah?
Yeah, complete sell out, yeah.
Added some more dates. Steve, you got the extra dates there? Sort of. What, Birmingham, Bournemouth, Folkestone, Dunstable, Brighton and London. Yep. Enjoying the tour, are you?
Yeah, sure, it's great.
How long have you two known each other?
About three and a half years, yeah. 4 years.
In the band or as friends?
Well, friends, 2 years in the band.
I heard a story that the first time Pete ever did That's the Way I Like It was with a mate when he was about 14. Is that correct?
Well, it was a long time ago, about 6 years ago, with his first group mate.
I was 14 then. I'm 25 now, but it was with the first band I called Nightmares in Wax, and it was quite a long time ago, about 1978, when I did that song. And I just thought it was quite a funny song, so when we came to do this LP, I thought we'd record it, and I thought it was quite funny. Now it's bringing in money, it's not so funny, but I really think this is serious.
I love this gear you're wearing. What's all this business?
I borrowed it off you.
What, my computer?
yes.
Has your attitude changed since you were a teenager? I mean, you were fairly extrovert then, I mean, quite extrovert now.
No, my attitude hasn't changed. It's just that, you know, you grow up a bit, you know. I think I've got a bit crabbier. But,
yeah, I mean, they actually say that you're not only one of the wittiest, but also got got a very biting tongue as well in the rock business.
Yeah. Well, you know, just born with a gift like that. I think in this business, you've either got to have quite a sharp tongue or go down, you know, miserably. I can stand up for myself there, but
future plans for the band after the tour?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to have a baby. Yeah, that's it.
So, revealing everything here tonight. Thank you both very much. Anyway.